Hey guys, this is AC Service Tech, and today what we're looking at is the basic refrigeration cycle. Alright, so you can take this as looking at it as if it's just a standard air conditioning system. Alright, so you have two items that separate the low pressure and the high pressure on this system. And the one is the compressor that's up high, and then the other is the metering device where in this picture you see it's down low. Alright, so how the refrigeration cycle works is it takes low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant, it comes into the compressor, and out of the compressor it comes out as a high temperature, high pressure vapor refrigerant. In fact, it's at its hottest spot on the entire system right there. As it enters into the condenser coil, it starts rejecting heat. As it rejects heat, it starts turning into a saturated state in the middle of the condenser coil. All right, a saturated state is where vapor and liquid both exist at the same time. All right, so right there, right after the saturated state, where it turns into a complete liquid until where it comes out right next to the service valve, the temperature decrease as it's rejecting heat, the temperature decrease in liquid form is called the subcooling. All right, the saturated state is where it's transferring most of its energy at. Alright, the refrigerant is what is carrying the heat and moving it, rejecting it and absorbing it in the refrigerant itself. And most of that energy transfer occurs right in that saturated state. Alright, so it comes from the saturated state in the middle of the condenser coil. It continues to reject heat as a complete liquid until it comes out of the condenser coil. Then it comes down in the picture here, and then it makes a left, and then it goes in through the filter dryer. The filter dryer is there to absorb any moisture in the system. All right, it has a fixed capacity and that's it. All right, it comes through that and then it hits the metering device. The metering device allows for a pressure change. All right, when you have a pressure change, so you have high temperature, high pressure liquid refrigerant coming into the metering device and then it turns it into a low pressure, then what happens is it automatically makes it a low temperature as well. So if you decrease temperature, then pressure will decrease. If you decrease pressure, then temperature will decrease. So in this case, we have a high pressure, high temperature liquid refrigerant coming through and hitting the metering device. The metering device is only going to allow a small amount through, all right? And then it turns into a low pressure, low temperature, 80% liquid, 20% flash gas mix. But it's mainly going to be a low temperature, low pressure liquid. All right, until it gets to the middle of the evaporator coil. So the refrigerant is actually absorbing heat once it enters into the evaporator coil. As it absorbs enough heat, it turns into that saturated state in the middle of the evaporator coil, all right, where most of the energy absorption is taking place. And then right after that is where it turns into a low pressure, low temperature vapor. All right after the saturated state, it turns into that low pressure, low temperature vapor, all right, until where it comes out of the evaporator coil, it's still absorbing heat. As it comes out of the evaporator coil, right at that point right there, the temperature increase from the saturated state in vapor, right at the end of the saturated state in vapor, to where it comes out, that's called the superheat. If you continue along, you keep coming up as a low pressure, low temperature vapor. You come up and then you make a right, and then you come over to the service valve. All right, so that's where we take a superheat reading at. All right, so if you took right in the middle of the evaporator coil, right after the saturated state where it turns into a complete vapor, the temperature increased from there all the way over to the service valve next to the compressor, that's called the total superheat. All right, after that, it just enters back into the compressor as a low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant, and the refrigerant cycle starts all over again. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed yourself, and we'll see you next time at AC Service Tech Channel.